Welcome to the third episode of the Linux command line ultimate tutorial. In this video, you will learn how to get a little more information about files using the Linux command line, as well as how to view files from the Linux command line. And we start right after the channel intro. Let's open the terminal. Now I press F11 to make this terminal full screen. And I hope you remember the command cd, which means to change the current working directory. And I will navigate to my public folder. And here I also would like to remind you the command ls, which means to list the content of the working directory. This is what you learned so far. But now let's assume you want to get more information about the files in this directory. So you can use the command ls with the option l, and this option means to show the extended view of the ls command. So the first column just shows the access rights for different files and folders. As you can see here, it is different for some files and folders, but I will explain this in details in another video. The second column shows the number of hard links to each of these files and folders. This will be covered also in another episode. Then we have the owner of the file. So as you can see, most of these files are owned by the regular user, LU, but some files are also owned by root. I deliberately created this root file just to show you the difference. And this column shows the group where the file belongs to. The most interesting is probably this column because it contains the information about the size of the file in bytes. And this column is pretty obvious, it contains the information about when the file was modified last time, and then you have the name of the files. So here I would like to introduce you the available options for different commands. So if you type the command, then you can specify the option for that command, in this case we use the option L, and in case of ls you can leave it empty, it will print you the content of the current working directory, or you can specify the specific folder which you want to list. For example, if you type /, you should remember it from the previous episode, that it will list the content of the directory which is one level up, in this case it will be my home directory. And we can get detailed list of all the folders in my home directory. So let's clean this screen. If you want to learn more about different options and for different commands, you can use this, the command you are interested in, and then you type the option help, and it will print you all the available options. For example, here we use the option L, which means to use a long list format. There are many more options, for example in this video, we will use the option A, which means to print all the files, in this case the ones which are hidden files. The name of this file starts with a dot. And we will also have a look at the option human readable format. So this option will show the size of the files in kilobytes, megabytes, something that is a bit easier for human to read. And the last option I will also show you is the option S. This option means to sort files. Oh yeah, and I will also show you the option reverse, it's here, so we can also sort and then we can reverse the order of the files in that sorting. So let's clean this screen, I press Ctrl L, and you can get the same information with the command man ls, but in this case man is the command which we apply to the ls command to get the documentation about this file. Basically it is almost the same as ls with the option help. I usually use ls help or any other command with the option help, but sometimes the command doesn't have built-in help, so you can use man if you don't get help message with the option help. So you type enter, it is also a bit easier to read because you get some highlighting here, again you remember the option A will show us the names of the file which start with the dot. You can scroll and read, it basically is the same what I have shown you before. To exit from the man page, it's a bit different from before, you need to press the Q key on your keyboard and you will exit. So let's have a look at these options in more details. If you type ls with option L and you add option H, which means to show human readable size format, you will get much better information. You see now we have 29 kilobytes here, 4 kilobytes or just 12 bytes. Previously it looked like this. If you have a very large file, this number can get very big, and then it will be difficult to see how many digits you have in that number. but with option H for human readability, you will get a bit nicer numbers. So if you type ls with option A, it will show you the hidden files. So here we have the .directory, which is a standard file for every directory in Linux. Then I also created a hidden file just to demonstrate you if you type ls, we don't have hidden file, we don't have directory file. And here you also have these two dots and one dot, which are not exactly files, it's kind of redirection. For example, if you type cd dot, it means to navigate into this directory, so it will not do anything. But if you type two dots, it will navigate you one level up. You should remember all of this from my previous episodes. So let's clean this screen and let's have a look at the options to sort files by size. If you type ls with option L and big S, the files will be sorted by size with the largest file at the top. So you can see this is the largest file, this is the smallest. So if you press the key up on your keyboard, you will scroll back in the history of your commands. You will see this command again. And we also add option small r here, which means to reverse the order. And now we have the opposite order in the smallest file at the top and the largest file at the bottom. So you can again use the command man ls or ls with option help to get more information about the available options for the command ls. But these are the options I use most frequently, and I think it should be enough for most of the users. So let's clean the screen again. Now if you want to get even more details about the file, you can use the command file and the name of the file you want to get information about. For example, if I type file and this JPEG file, I can see that this is JPEG with some information, but the most interesting is that it is 1800 by 1800 pixel size. So this is very useful because you don't need to open a file to see its resolution. You just type the command file and the name of the image and you will get the size of this image. I use it pretty often. You can use the same with any other file format. If I type file sift-awk, you can see that it is a script and you can also see that it is executable. So let's clean the screen again. And the last topic I want to cover in this episode is how to use the content of files in your Linux system from the command line. The easiest way to use the content of the file is to type command ls and the name of the file. For example, for this video I will use Trump president speech. So, and it will open you this file. If you press the arrow keys on your keyboard, you can scroll down and you can scroll up. If you want to go to the end of the file, you need to press Shift G. And now you are at the end of the file. If you want to go back to the beginning of the file, you need to press the letter G, just small g without shift. And you will be navigated back to the beginning of this file. Another useful feature can be if you want to find specific word in this file. You type slash and you type the word. For example, let's type America. Now the word is highlighted, so you can scroll and see where this word occurs. This is very useful. And again, you type small g to go to the beginning of the file and shift g to go to the end of the file. If you want to exit from the ls command, you need to type the letter q, which was the same for the man page. Q means to quit, so you type q and you quit from this command. And if you want to know just one command to use the content of the file, you should be using ls. But if you want to be an advanced user, you can use a couple of more commands. For example, if you want just to see the beginning of the file, basically the head of the file, you type literally the command head and the name of the file, and it will print you the first 10 lines of that file. You can do the same with the command tail. If you type tail, the name of the file, it will show you the last 10 lines of that file, as you can see here. So let's clean this screen. You can also have a look at different options in these commands. For example, if you type head with option N and you say, for example, 15, it will print you 15 first line of this file. You see, it's a bit bigger than before. And you can do the same with the command tail. If you type command tail, you type N and you just want to see the last line of that file. You press and you are shown only the one line of that file. you can see the other options again using the command man. Here you can see you can list the content in bytes. For example, you want to limit the output only to a specific number of bytes. By default, it uses number of lines, and there are not many options. And again, you press letter Q to quit from the man page. Now I would like to show you the last command. This command is used if you want to see the content of the file and you are sure that the file is small. For example, from here I can see that the trump file is quite big for a text file, so it will be much larger than this screen. But if I open some other files, for example, let's see the content of this sift file. If I type cat and the name of this file, it will print me the content of that file to the screen. As you can see, it's not a very big file here. But if I try to see the content of a larger file, cat will be useless. Let me show you. If I type cat temp, so you see it printed everything, so I can see only the last lines, and then I need to scroll up until the beginning of this file. And the file is very big, so it's not that easy to use the cat command. So for the big files, you better use the less command. So let's clean this screen and repeat what we have learned in this episode. You can use the command ls with option l to get more detailed information about your files. If you add option a, you will also see the hidden files. If you want your output to be human readable, you need to add option h. And if you want to sort your files with the file size, you need to add option s. And if you want to reverse the sorting, you need to add option r. So this is with the ls command. In addition to this, you can use the command file, which will give you detailed information about a specific file. It's useful for images, for example, to see the resolution of the file. And if you want to see the content of the file, you are better use the command less. But if you just want to quickly check the head of the file, you use the command head. To check the end of the file, you use the command tail. And if you know that your file is very small, you can also use the command cat to print it on the screen. And you also learned that you can use different options for different commands. And to get more information about specific options, you need to type the command and the option help. Or alternatively, you can use also the command man and the name of the command you want to check. And again, to exit from the man page or from the less command, you need to press the key Q on your keyboard, which means to quit. I hope you find this series useful and you are learning something new. So please subscribe if you are not subscribed yet. In the next episode, you will learn how to create links to files and folders in the Linux command line. Thank you for watching!